In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be with you all, and with your spirit. In the waters of baptism, Dolores died with Christ, and rose with him to new life. May she know, share with him eternal glory.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander
in the silence of our hearts, let's pray for the faithful departed. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant, Dolores, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you. The unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with the word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I'm going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you're going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Family members of Dolores, friends, and all gathered here. At the very outset, on behalf of our parish family, let me convey our deepest sympathy at your loss. When we come into this world, there is one certainty in life. That one day we all die. But when it comes to our loved ones, it brings us pain and sorrow. But as Christians, the readings of today gives us comfort and hope. The first reading, taken from the Book of Wisdom. The author says, "A just person, even after death, lives forever." Now, for the Hebrews, a just person means a person who lives a life according to the commandments of God. So anyone who believes or lives a life according to the commandments of God, death is not the end. It's a transition. One enters from life to life, from mortality to immortality. We'll listen to the gospel passage. What Jesus make three claims. He says, he is the way. He is the truth. And he is life. Now we read the Old Testament. The prophet says, thus says the Lord. They conveyed the message of God. Now Jesus comes, the word itself. Or John would say, the word which became flesh. He says, he is the way to the one true God. You know, we can speak about different ways of knowing God. But as human beings, we can never claim to be the way. Jesus could because he is God himself. Secondly, he says, he is truth. You know, at the trial, Pilate asked Jesus a question. What is the truth? Jesus did not give an answer. The reason, he himself is the truth. What is truth? God is the ultimate truth. As St. Thomas would say, the highest good. So Jesus is God, so he is truth. And thirdly, he is life. John says, Jesus came into this world so that we may have life in abundance. The second reading, letter of Paul to Thessalonians. Paul says, if Jesus died and rose from the dead, and when we believe in him, we can share in his resurrection. For a Christian, death is not the end. It's a beginning of a new life, a new life in the person of Jesus Christ. We come from God, we return back to God. As family and friends, we have gathered here today to remember and pray for your mother, your sister, your friend. When I sat with the family for the funeral preparation, you have a lot of good things to say about Dolores. A wonderful human being. Catholic faith was very important to her. She loved her parish and prayed the rosary every day. Dolores loved her family, grandkids, and great-grandkids. Loved to watch them at sports. She loved outdoors, gardening, walking, biking, and always remained very active and healthy. A hard worker, loved life, loved her family and people around her. 90 years, good long life. But these days, for a woman, 90 years is not, it's just beginning. You know, those who are well in their 90s, they live at home and enjoy good health. But still, 90 years living healthy, it's wonderful. Lived a life in its fullest and has gone for her eternal reward. As we continue this Eucharistic celebration, let's thank the good Lord for the gift of your mom, your sister, your friend, your grandma, your great-grandma. And ask the good Lord, be merciful upon her, forgive all her sins, and grant her eternal rest. Please rise. Let us in faith call upon God the Almighty Father, who raised Jesus Christ, his Son, from the dead, as we pray for the salvation of the living and the dead.
In baptism, Dolores received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister Dolores was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us, especially her husband Bernard, 9 brothers, Apollinary, Daniel, Everett, Roland, Richard, Adrian, Linus, Larry, and Michael Waldera, 2 sisters, Adeline Slaby and Evelyn Severson Gamroth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trust in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment and peace and rest to all whose faith is known to you alone, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray to our sister Dolores. Strengthen our hopes so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trust in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Dolores Kulig, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
May the prayer of those who cry to you benefit the soul of your servant Dolores, O Lord. Free her, we pray, from all her sins, and make her cherish in your redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Story, God of all creation, through the necessary practical for the eternal work of your man, sit and wait for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. By the mingling of this wine and water, we may come to share the divine to Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed Lord God of all creation, through your necessary wine, to your foot of the wine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Please rise. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept your sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and good of all his holy church. As we humbly present it to you, these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Dolores, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let's give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and we look forward to the second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope, William our Bishop, the order of the bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Dolores, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son at death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, O God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Please rise. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Or lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace and joy of the Lord be with you always and with your spirit. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Please be seated. For those who are visiting us for the reception of the communion, first, the right hand, the right hand side of the aisles, please come up in social distancing and please make use of the sanitizers. And then the left hand side of the aisle.
Rejoice and be glad.
Please rise. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Dolores may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
To her aid, O saints of God, come meet her angels of the Lord, receive her souls, O holy ones, present her now to God most high. May Christ, who called you, take you home, and angels lead you to Abraham. Receive her soul, O holy ones, present her now to God most high. Give her eternal rest, O Lord. May light unending shine on her. Receive her soul, O holy ones. Present her now to God most high. I know that my Redeemer lives. The last day I shall rise again. Receive her soul, O holy ones. Present her now to God most high.
Into your hand, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Dolores in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever, through Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest. That concludes the service here in the church. So thank you everyone for joining the family. Now we will process over to the cemetery for the final committal. You're all welcome to join the family.
Joy this blessed assurance gives. trust.